Hello and good morning, friends. Today I want to talk to you about bull run valves. What are they? Where do they look? What do they look like? And where are you going to find them? What type of systems are they? Are they good? Are they bad? All these good things are wonderful things to talk about. So let's go ahead and dive right into it. So septic systems, right? You're going to have a tank and then you're going to have an absorption system. Sometimes they come in a variety of shapes and sizes and colors, but it will almost always end up being in that orientation. It'll be tank first, then it'll be whatever type of absorption system you have. Now, you have to basically divert some of that water, especially if you have multiple trenches or multiple legs. For example, most of the homes in our area, you'll have one tank and then you'll have 2 to 3 drain fields. Sometimes they'll be long, sometimes they won't be long. But commonly, you have to separate them in some way, shape, or form. Most commonly nowadays, we're going to use these things called distribution boxes. We've covered distribution boxes previously in other videos, but basically all a distribution box is a little tiny concrete deal where the water from the tank goes into and then disperses evenly into your trench lines. That is the easy, simple way that we do things nowadays. Older systems sometimes would have used serial distribution, which is basically where they have one leg of trench, goes back, comes back on itself, and it just does that over and over until you get to whatever your desired linear feet is. Sometimes you would have basically a Y split, and it would just be one pipe in, one to the left, one to the right. That style was incredibly problematic, right? You know, let's just say that you have a clog on the left leg, but for whatever reason, your auger always wants to go to the right. Guess what? Now you have to dig up the pipe in order to fix it. Or hopefully you can go back the other direction, which doesn't always work out that way. So we stopped doing that. Now, with a bull run valve, which is why we're here, a bull run valve was generally used in order to separate an existing system from a new system. So for example, this particular property has a tank, bull run valve. To the left is going to be a pit with a trench off the back. To the right is going to be a distribution box with 2 trenches. Now, the system to the left was the original system, and that's what was once serving this property. But by using the bull run valve, when the system to the right decides to stop working, you can actually switch back to the one on the left. This is incredibly common for houses that are older to do, right? And a lot of times, depending on how the system's set up, you might actually every 2 or 3 years switch between both of those legs. I don't usually see that very often. Most of the time, if I do see people switching every couple years, it's going to be because of some kind of soil issue. So what they'll do is they'll put 2 zones in, they'll do 2 drain fields to the left, 2 drain fields to the right, and then you'll alternate between the two. Sometimes, if you have a pump chamber and you have 2 zones, you might do the same thing, but it'll actually dose to each one. I don't usually see that too much, except for in Frederick County. That's really the only county that I'll see people doing dual zone systems, but it's something that pops up every now and again. A bull run valve is very simple, right? Basically, like I said, it's just a Y-split with a little knuckle on top that you can rotate in order to turn. You're not gonna see it very often, but when you do see it, you'll usually see a little 4-inch PVC cleanout. So let's go take a look and see what it actually looks like in the field. All right, so we can see here that we have our tank, which is this green lid right over here. And if we follow behind the tank, we'll see this 4-inch pipe right here. This is gonna be the bull run valve. Now it's closed, obviously, but if you were to open this up, you would see the knuckle inside, and that's how you would rotate the valve. Now, the one directly behind it is going to be the original system with the pit, which is going to be that pipe over there. The modern system is going to actually go from here all the way up to this little fella. This little fella is going to be our distribution box. These observation ports are incredibly common and required by code on any home that has a septic system installed after 2012, essentially. Basically, what this is for is so that way if you have an issue, you can pop it open, take a look inside, and see what's going on. The benefit of having that is, let's just say you have a problem, right? Let's just say that you go ahead and you have a backup in your house, and you're not entirely sure what's causing the backup. Popping that lid open makes it to where you can tell, is it a drain field issue? Is it a pipe between the two issue? Or is it something in the home? From the distribution box, we'll actually see the trench lines going all the way up over to the fence over there, where we see 2 more small 4-inch white pipes right over yonder. That's going to be the secondary system, right? It's the new primary since the old one failed, but that's how they separate them. You don't usually see bull runs too often, but if you do have something that's kind of like weird and out of place and you're not entirely sure what it is, it might actually be a bull run. Pop those lids off, take a look inside, see what's actually in there. I wanted to make a quick video on it because I think that they're fun. You don't really see them very often. If you found this informative or if you gained any value in any way, hit that like button, hit subscribe. I have more videos posted every day on the World of Well and Septic, and I look forward to talking to you tomorrow.